بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهد الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله بالهدى ودين الحق له، صلى الله تبارك وتعالى عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وبارك وسلم. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، فأصني مسلما وألحقني بالصالحين. وقال الله مولانا العلي العظيم، وبلغنا رسوله النبي الكريم الأمين المكين، ونحن على ذلك لمن الشاهدين والشاكرين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. غوث يا غضم بمن بيسر وسامة مدد قبل ايدي مدد كعبة ايما مدد انتظار كرم تست من عيني را اي خدا جويو خدا بينو خدا دا مدد. ان الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا ايها الذين امنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا وعلى محمد في الزمان شفاء، وقل بالقلوب دواء من الاسفار، ويا علي وحبيب عليك وسلم. My brothers in Islam, we are very fortunate as we are following a way which has been called in this age by the name of Masake and the Sunnat wal Jamaat. And Masake and the Sunnat wal Jamaat has been identified by another name, among us Ahle Sunnat wal Jamaat, we used to call it Maslake Ala Hazrat. What is Maslake Ala Hazrat? There is a question comes to one's mind: did Ala Hazrat innovate any religion in his name? Answering to this question, I would like to say Ala Hazrat never innovated any new religion in his name. This is the Maslake Ahle Sunnat which has been identified in this age by the name and by the title of Maslake Ala Hazrat. And what is Maslake Ala Hazrat? Maslake Ala Hazrat is to praise Holy Prophet Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu tabaraka wa ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. And Maslake Ala Hazrat is to pay devotion and submission and respect to Holy Prophet Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu tabaraka wa ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. And Maslake Ala Hazrat means to be in touch, to be attached with the pious personalities, with the favorite of Allah, with the saints of Allah. In this connection, I just recited one verse of Holy Quran in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reporting from Hazrat Yusuf ala nabiyyina wa alayhi salatu wa taslim. He is saying, when his time came near to pass away from this world, at that time Sayyidina Yusuf ala nabiyyina wa alayhi salatu wa taslim invoked and called Almighty Allah, O Allah, make me pass away as a Muslim and attach me with the pious persons. Attach me with the persons who have got ability to be close to your court. One thing should be noted first of all. A Nabi, a Rasul, a prophet has been classified in the very higher rank of mankind. Prophet cannot commit sin. Prophet is very far from evil doing. So why Sayyidina Yusuf ala nabiyyina wa alayhi salam says like this, O Allah, make me pass away as a Muslim? Is he doubting about his iman? Is he fearing might he face any untoward incident? Might he has evil end? So answering to this question, I just like to clarify that this invocation, which seems apparently obviously as a statement made by Sayyidina Yusuf ala nabiyyina wa alayhi salatu wa taslim, but this invocation made by Sayyidina Yusuf ala nabiyyina wa alayhi salatu wa taslim was not for him. This invocation was for his ummah, to instruct his ummah, to teach his ummah, and to teach every Muslim besides Prophet how to keep in touch with the pious personalities. So this way, Sayyidina Yusuf ala nabiyyina wa alayhi salatu wa taslim taught us and instructed us that we should try to keep in touch always with the pious persons and to ask Allah that may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us always with the pious persons and keep keep us in touch with them all the time. Through this, you can derive that the pious persons have got much more importance in the court of Allah. This is the reason why he and the Sunnah wal Jamaat try to be close with the Salihin. We try to be close with the pious persons. We intend to be attached with the favorite of Allah. So we are very lucky. And we have pious persons amongst us. And we are very lucky because we try to keep in touch with them, and as we try to keep in touch with them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed upon us that He granted us connection, which is never ending connection with the pious person. And he is the one who denies the dignity and the importance of pious persons. And it is a Sunni who tries in the light of Sharia, in the light of teachings of Quran, to keep us, to keep in touch with the pious persons. So I just make dua. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us connected all the time with the pious person in this world and when we pass away from this world. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us under the shelter of Sayyidina Ghawse Azam and Awliya-i-Kiram and the Salihin and the pious persons and the favorite of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's okay, but that's